We've got Terry Fennick, men's senior team head coach, here with us. Terry, first training session for this week. This is your second week. You've got the inclusion of a few overseas-based players today, which is a positive sign for you.
Absolutely. It's great to see them back in Trinidad. And when I look at, you know, Guerra and Primus, Joseph, Marvin Phillip, you've got some excellent names there that the public are well aware of. They've been in quarantine, and this is them starting back with the national side. So great to have that experience around us.
When you look at the numbers that you have now, what is your assessment? Still early days, but what can we see from you over the next few days, coming weeks?
Sean, what I'm trying to achieve here is, over time, my numbers will go down, as well as the age group will go down. I'm looking for a very young, vibrant Trinidad and Tobago local national side. And by young, I'm talking 16 through to 21, that's what I'm looking at. So I can get development into these youngsters, and they're learning different things. And it's not kids that have come out of college league football at 20. I need them to get development sessions over a number of years before they hit their 20s.
Still though, you have the likes of a Molino, Joving Jones. These guys are coming off full season in the MLS. They're going to be available to you in the next few weeks. We can look forward to having them in your mix as well.
Absolutely. I think first and foremost, let the guys have a break. My God, we've had a difficult year with COVID virus. It's sent football crazy. You're playing in front of, you know, stadiums with no crowds, but they're still doing a great job for their clubs overseas. I'd like them to come back, get familiar with family all over again, enjoy themselves for a week, maybe two. But then when they come back into my national squad, I want them to share their experiences of overseas, what they do with their club sides, so we can share that information, that intelligence, and move our youngsters on quicker than we are.
So we have national senior team goalkeeper Marvin Phillip is here with us. Marvin, it's so good to see you back after a long layoff. Obviously, we know with the COVID, the pandemic, you were out there in India as well, doing your thing, and now you're back home. First session, how you felt?
Definitely, it's always a pleasure to be back with the national team. Today's session was great, you know, it's just to get back myself, to get a rhythm, to fine-tune certain things. And glad to be back out.
First session on the new management, on the new head coach, what are your impressions on that?
It's good. I have worked with Terry before at the club level with Djibouti. He's a pretty decent coach, and he gets a lot out of the players.
Tell us about your stint in India, obviously being there, you know, football is on the rise across there with the league. What was it like across there?
It was definitely a great experience, you know, until the pandemic came. the league itself, it's growing, you know, a lot of foreign players coming from Africa, Spain, a lot from the Caribbean, like Trinidad itself, so the league is growing.
And what can we expect from you now? Are you back home now with the pandemic? Are you looking to get back outside, or you try to see if you can get involved in the domestic league when it starts?
There are some offers on the table right now, but it's just that's not concrete. Hopefully something concrete will come along and I'll be back out soon.
How important it is for us to be active again now, because we've seen what has gone on with the association over the past 6 to 8 months. Players like yourself have been looking on, concerned obviously, but now, you know, things are starting to get active again. Obviously it's a positive sign for us. How you felt about it?
Definitely a positive sign, you know, as you said, players were out of football for 8 to 9 months, you know. We know the pandemic is going on, so we'll definitely be closer here. So the onus is on the players to put in that hard work to have themselves sharp and ready for when international football is ready. The administrators, they have the work to do, they have their work cut out for them, but you know, we as players have to put in the work for us to make sure that we are physically ready for when international football is ready to start. And we want to let them and the country know that they could depend on us for us to do our part.